Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Thank you.
Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
When's the last time I had to dig through clothes? It won't play without any power. Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop. But I love how funky and outdated it is. She even covered it in punk stickers because I think this junk swallowed her discs. Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. I'm not into them. Too pretentious. We had such a blast drawing these together.
You broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared. Oh, this is a flashback to Youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. She looks super happy. She looks super stoned. I think this junk swallowed her discs.
You are ridiculous. I don't see you for 5 years and your first response is to break my glass snow dough. Thanks, Max. Now please put on some music and let me smoke out by myself for a bit.
It won't play without any power. She looks super happy. We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Nothing's changed, except for me and Chloe. These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why. Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything.
Goodbye to the roses on your street.
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Joy still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. The tools might be in this cupboard. Fingers. Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird. The tools might be in this cupboard. Nothing. This is so lame. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Poor little dear. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass. I guess they're aging these books. This is so lame. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. No need to go there now. Always make them fall. I don't want to look at these creepy photos again. Why does David have them? The tools might be in this cupboard. Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Man, I should have done that before they fell. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills. Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it. Dog tags. Sweet. David Mattson.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
No, I look a lot different.
I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
Dad, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
I was freaking out. I could only hear Nathan ranting.
So then you did hear us.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs,
but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
No, I didn't know what to do.
I don't blame you. That's some intense shit.
Maybe I should go to the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
Fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes! Break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off! Turn it off!
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing.
I'm not kidding you. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
Let me in now, please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door. I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. 1, 2, 3.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends. I ordered you to never go through my files. You obviously have.
I didn't touch your files, David. I could care less about your files.
You care about starting shit, Chloe, and it's getting old. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Is this true?
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. Now, do
get
you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape.
Wowzer, Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency. Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it. How long has that been here?
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
My pleasure. Feels nice out here after all that drama.
You really took one for Team Chloe.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
I should have taken his photo when he flipped out on Kate today.
That would be killer blackmail material. Let's bust his ass.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Well, yeah, I couldn't help it.
Never change. What did you find?
Creepy photos of Kate Marsh, other Blackwell students.
This dude takes his job too seriously. He still thinks he's at war or something. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it! He is so hella fucking paranoid! I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
I am so furious, I can't even speak. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Why am I here again?
I wonder how we'll get around this. Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away. Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town.
Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? Totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years, which is so.
No, no, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But Ty, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. Mrs. Hoyda is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing. I miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds. can't leave without my shower supplies. Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
Not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it. Consider it done.
Ow!
One quick rewind and I could stop this TP attack.
Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off.
Chloe is so determined to find you, Rachel.
Macking on those bros?
We shouldn't be watching this.
Everybody's seen it by now.
Hey, Max. Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing did. Didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yuck! I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Max Selfie thought she was a badass taking that picture. I should have beat her down.
That was so uncool.
She's jealous because Mark... Mr. Jefferson knows I'm going to win the Everyday Heroes contest. He thinks Max is a joke.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
Ha, 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 ha.
better get dressed than go give back Kate's book. No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book. Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. Ta-da! I do love a clean room. Very zen. Except for that bullshit graffiti. My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there. Hold up, I need to find the book before going to see Kate. No book here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now. Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Hey, Kate. I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullying. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Are you sure it was just one sip?
I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And...
And?
That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag. So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I would...
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut.
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week. Ouch. She left out amnation. That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy. That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed. The birds are flocking around Samuel.
Max, come on over here.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
By the way, stepping in, you were pretty badass, Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I was too scared to tell Principal Wells. Please, don't say anything. I'll give you more info later.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
No, I don't think I can concentrate on going out to the movies. I just feel like escaping.
Fine. Be a damn dirty human. I'll go ape myself.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Take it from me. It's mine.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
Smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again. I might make Chloe check this out with me. Why does that so not sound fun?
And there she is, a lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. Very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle, and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did, after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories, even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did. And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
One Belgian waffle at 12 o'clock high.
I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
No beer? What kind of dive is this?
This is like fourth dimension.
Max, here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl, a woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way, let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
You have a tube of glitter in there, right?
Nada. Wrong answer. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
You need to look. Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything. Hello? This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max, I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A pixel heart keychain.
A what? Do you even know me? Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want.
So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max, I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
13 cigarettes.
I smoke too much to have 13 cigarettes. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me.
Okay, Max, study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind. So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
$0.25.
You lose. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max, study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind.
So,
this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
A parking ticket.
You know me well.
But what is the exact time I was busted?
"10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time!
Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
$0.82.
I wish. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail.
So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Supermax. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
A parking ticket.
You know me well.
But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time!
Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay.
Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops!
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh! Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick!
Don't slap me, bitch! Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That's the best song I've
this
heard
yet. This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power. I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and he quickly exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor fight, and Joyce doesn't give a shit.
This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops!
Dude,
did you
right.
break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh! Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
don't
not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
You are really whiffing this. Fucking
A.
This is
yet.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and he quickly exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Dude,
did you
right.
break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
dope.
Not,
slap
Max.
Slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild. Fucking A.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power. I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and he answers it.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Dude,
did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
dick.
Not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild. Fucking A.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.